Hey my loves, welcome back to my channel. Wanted to say welcome back. Welcome back guys, welcome back. But today is a first impression video on these bad boys. These bad boys, woo! You guys will know on how I like them or not at the end of this video. So stay tuned. You guys don't wanna miss out. Y'all don't wanna miss out. So watch the whole video, man. Watch the whole video. I'm just letting you know. I have my little eyes on you. But please do not forget to subscribe to my channel and like this video. That will help me so much. And I want to say I appreciate you guys. I always say this, but I really do appreciate you guys. You guys are the best in the world. I can't say that enough. I really can't say that enough. I can't thank you guys enough for the love and support. Seriously, we are almost at 200 subscribers, guys. That's super exciting to me. I wanted to let you guys know that this isn't a tutorial. This is basically me just putting on makeup and using these two products for the first time and basically you guys seeing on how I react to it. So without further ado, let's just get on to the video. But we're gonna do a first impression today. Yes! Of two things. The Morphe Copper Palette. I mean the Morphe Copper Brush Set and then the... I never like to start with my face because I feel like my face makeup doesn't look as great if I do my face first instead of doing my eyes, you know what I mean? So, we're gonna start with our eyes as usual. So, to start off today's look, we're gonna go in with this like orangey brown shade. Whoops. From the Carly Bible Deluxe palette with one of Morphe's brushes. I've never used these before, so this is my first impressions. Let's see how this goes. Oh wow. Brushes are super soft. The eyeshadow is super pretty. It's blendable. It blends super easily. Like, I barely tapped on the eyeshadow and it's given me a lot of pigment. I'm barely blending it out and it seems like it's just blending out so effortlessly. I'm loving this brush. I love tapered blending brushes because honestly, it just feels like blends it basically for you. Yes, I'm feeling this palette so far. Honestly, I don't even know what look I'm gonna do yet. So let's just see. I'm gonna go with this purpley shade right here. Yeah, I'm just gonna define my crease a little bit more. See how this purple goes. Everything is super pigmented. I'll do a couple swatches in a bit. These are super pigmented, guys. For only like, I think I spent like 22 bucks. Oh, see guys, look how pigmented that is. That's crazy pigmented. Okay, I'm gonna be going back in with that same brush I used for that transition shade. And I'm gonna be blending that a little bit higher because I felt like I kind of just blended it a little bit low today. These brushes too are bomb. These brushes honestly like basically like do the job for you. That's what I feel like. I feel like I'm blending like so effortlessly right now. I'm gonna be taking the darkest brown shade in the palette. I wish these brushes had names. They don't have names, so I can't really say. And I'm gonna be focusing that on the outer corners. Some have like shimmer in them, but once you pack it on, you can't see the shimmer. It's like invisible. Loving this palette. I'm seriously loving this palette. I'm trying to use as much shades as I can so I get the most, you know, feeling out of it to see if it's really that great. Some palettes come with only like half amazing shades and then the other half is like shit. I don't really think this palette is really like that because honestly, they're like pigmented and just super blendable. And that's key. And I haven't been getting any fallout, which is a fucking plus for me. Oh, I'm just taking that purpley shade again. And I'm gonna be blending that right on top. Cause you really don't wanna lose that gradient effect. Wow. I am honestly I'm super impressed right now. Carly Bible, you always do it. You always do it, Carly Bible. You always do it. Ooh. I'm loving these two shades. These two shades are like calling my name. So I'm thinking I'm gonna use both of them today. One on the inner portion of my lid and one on the middle portion of my lid. But I have to cut my crease because that is my life. So if I don't cut my crease, guys, I know I feel like I'm over exaggerating, but if I don't cut my crease, literally the lid color will definitely transfer on my crease and my whole makeup look is fucked. fucked, I tell you. So I'm going in with MAC Soft Ochre Paint Pot. Per usual, y'all already know. And I'm gonna cut that crease. You know what I mean? Remember, you wanna cut your crease where your crease folds, because that is the point to the cut creases, because if you don't, like I said, it will transfer on your crease and your makeup look is screwed. I'm only cutting the crease halfway, by the way. All right, guys, so far, so good.
Everything that I used on my eyes blended out so nicely. Everything blended out so nicely. I am shook.
But I'm gonna set my lids with Coty's Airspun powder. Okay, like they have a packer brush, but I feel like it's too big, but we'll see. I'm gonna go in with this shade right there. I'm gonna add that to the inner portion of my lid. So I'm not liking that brush to pack on my eyeshadow, I'm not gonna lie. I think it just didn't pack on the way it should have looked like. You know what I mean? I feel like synthetic brushes pack on better shimmery shades compared to like goat hair bristles, if you know what I mean. I say it, if you know what I mean, so much. I'm sorry, guys. I just do. I'm gonna try that again. I'm gonna be taking that same shade and I'm gonna be packing that to the inner portion of my lid. That was so much better. A lot better. And then I'm gonna be taking this pinker shade right there and I'm gonna be only applying that to the middle portion of my lids. This color, this color is freaking gorgeous. I don't have any eyeshadows that look like this color, so this is fucking pretty. All right, to blend everything out, I'm gonna be taking that dark brown again. Everything in this palette, guys, oh my gosh, blends so effortlessly. I'm taking that pencil brush from the copper brush set. I'm gonna do my eyeliner and my other eye off camera, so I'll be right back. I'm gonna be applying my eyelashes off camera, but I'm gonna let you guys know what I'm using. I'm gonna be using Flutter Lashes in the style Eye Slay. All right, I'm back, woo! Okay, before I do my face, I wanted to give you a little bit of swatches of a Carly Bible palette, cause you know, why not? Cause this is a first impressions, you know what I mean? I swatched this, look at that. That is pigmented. All right, let's do some matte colors because sometimes matte colors aren't so pigmented, but look. That is super pigmented, guys. Let's do another one. Look at that. That is super pigmented, guys. Because usually matte shades aren't as pigmented. There's kind of, sometimes they could be chalky and, you know. But honestly, wow. These are super pigmented. I am not going to lie. Let me do one more on my thumb. I just swatched that bronzy shade right there. Wow, guys, see, that's so pretty. That is, I am shook. It's only $22. I mean, come on, guys. It comes with highlighters, come on, guys. Like, you can never go wrong with highlighters, right? Right, I'm telling you, right? I mean, look, Kim comes with six highlighters. Compared to Anastasia, it's $40, it's $20. Anastasia Glow Kit is $40, comes with six highlighters. This is $20, comes with six highlighters, and let's see, 3, 9, 12. And it comes with 18 eyeshadow shades. Come on, guys, come on. Really, you never can go wrong. I am just saying. All right, for my face, let's start my face. You guys haven't seen me do my face in a while, so you know, let's do it. I'm gonna be taking Baby Skin to prime my face. I'm breaking out, but I've been using Curology. I got the free trial for a month. I wanted to try it out. I really wanted to see what the whole deal was, see if it was a bomb or not. And honestly, my skin has cleared up a lot. I know there's still little blemishes, but it cleared up a good amount in within like 3 days. So far, so good, I have to say. I'm gonna be going in with Milani's Conceal and Perfect 2-in-1 Foundation Concealer. My favorite drugstore foundation at the moment, for sure. When you pump out the foundation, you can tell it's full coverage because it's super thick. But honestly, it's super lightweight once you blend it out though. All right, I'm gonna try to blend that out with the stippling brush that comes with the Morphe copper brush set. And little hair shedded on me. Hopefully nothing else sheds. I mean guys, this set comes with 12 brushes and another one shedded. I don't know so far, I don't know about this brush yet. I don't know. Honestly though, it's blending out pretty nicely though. It's shedding on me, so that's kind of annoying. But it's blending out pretty nicely though. It's blending out my foundation pretty nice. Don't want to forget that neck of yours. You know what I mean? Oh, it kind of looks streaky, guys. I don't know. Let's keep on blending though. Yeah, don't like swipe. Use circular motions while you blend out the foundation with this brush. Yeah, use circular motions. That's better. Okay, that blended out pretty good, actually. If you use circular motions, it kind of takes away the streakiness of it. So definitely use circular motions if you want to blend this out with your foundation. But wow, look, it gave me, like, my face looks really good. Not gonna lie, it looks really good. I'm kind of shook. But it does take a while to blend out your foundation. So that's just a heads up for you guys right there. But the blending brushes are, yes, you have, yeah, you need it. These blending brushes are bomb. These blending brushes are bomb.com. Seriously, these blended out my eyeshadow today so seamlessly and so effortlessly. I'm shook. That's all I gotta say about that. I need to wear my beauty blender. Great, be right back. We are back in action, my friends. We are back in action. What? Conceal my underbags. I'm gonna be taking Maybelline's Fit Me Concealer, shade 20. This is my shit. I love this concealer so much. I love the Shark Tape Tape, the Shark Shape Tape Concealer a lot too. But you know, the Maybelline Fit Me is just more affordable. And honestly, I love it. It compares to high end. That's all I gotta say. So honestly guys, I don't know if I like the Beauty Blender that much. I mean, okay, Real Techniques Beauty Blender, I think honestly is better. Like, it's not as soft as a Beauty Blender. I'm not gonna say it's super soft, but I feel like it blends out my concealer a lot better. I'm just using the Beauty Blender because I kind of just bought it and it's $20, guys, so I'm gonna fucking use it. I'm not gonna just throw it away, the hell, you know? The first time I used it and I tried blending out my concealer, it literally took off my foundation and my concealer. It took off both. So all you saw was my freaking bare skin. And that was not the biz. I only used to wear foundation, no concealer or anything, and oh my gosh. I can't believe I would walk outside the house looking like that. All pale with just foundation, no bronzer, no nothing. Yeah, my forehead acne. I don't even know if it was acne or not, but there were just little bumps everywhere. Like, there's still a little bit right now, but it was worse. Like, the chorology is definitely, like, is the reason why they're slowly going away. But girl, they were so bad. Like, it was just bumps. Like, bumps with no color or anything. It wasn't even red or anything. And then they turned into little red bumps. And I was like freaking out and I didn't know what to do. And I'm gonna set my face with Coty's Air Spawn. I was so like, I don't know, like I was desperate. I was so desperate to just get rid of it. So I saw a video of this lady using Nizoral Dandruff Shampoo on her daughter. And she used it for 10 days and it freaking worked. Like her forehead bumps were gone. And so I went to go buy it, and honestly, it was fucking $14. Pretty expensive. Not gonna lie, for shampoo, you know? Like, I don't use expensive shampoo. I'm not that type of person who just will go and spend my money on shampoo, you know? But I was desperate. So I was like, okay, I'm gonna try this. And at first, I thought it was working out. It would dry out my forehead so much. It started getting patchy, and they kept coming back. Like, it would go away, but come back. Like, I don't know, it seemed like it would go away and then it would just come back and I felt like it would look worse. So I freaking stopped using that. And then I just got my Curology a couple days ago and I've been loving it ever since. It doesn't dry my skin. I thought it was going to because I have really dry skin, like really, really dry skin. Like there's no excess oil up in my skin. Woo. And so far, I love Curology. I am not gonna lie, guys. I'm not gonna say I highly recommend it yet because I haven't been using it for that long, but so far, so good. So I'll definitely keep you guys updated on how I like it when I'm almost done with a bottle. So is it just me? Okay, so if I set my whole face with translucent powder, I just look white, like white. Even if I put bronzer on, I look white. Okay, so if I pack on translucent powder on my face and I set it that way, my makeup will last all day. I'm not gonna lie. Like my makeup is bulletproof, sweatproof, everything. But after I do that, I'll set it again with my actual powder so I don't look so pale. If that happens to you guys, I highly recommend you to do that. Just set your face with translucent powder and then set it again with your actual powder that actually matches your skin tone. Just a little tip for you guys, you know? I'm gonna be setting my face now with Maybelline's Better Skin in Natural Beige, but I only like to apply this like on the outer portions of my face. And you don't wanna use circular motions because you don't wanna spread all that foundation that you just did. You don't wanna ruin that foundation you just put on, you know? So, I'm brightening up my under eyes with Kat Von D Shane Light Palette. I'm gonna be taking these two shades for my under eye highlight. Just to, you know, brighten up my eyes a little bit more. I never use this anymore. I used to use it all the time, but now I don't. I think I just forget about it, to be honest. See how much that brightens up my eyes? Ooh, I'm bright. I'm brighter than diamond. I'm gonna be using all Morphe brushes today. I always do. I love Morphe brushes, honestly. How can Morphe be so good but so affordable, you know? Like, that still does not make no sense to me. You wanna balance out highlight. You don't wanna just look bright underneath the eyes. You wanna look even, you know? So, definitely apply that everywhere you place your concealer. To bronze up my face, I'm gonna be taking my broken, look guys. This is my broken butter bronzer. I don't know what the heck happened. I put it in my carry-on when I went to California. Once I got back and went to go set up my makeup again, it was freaking broken. I'm like, what the hell? I was so gentle and everything else didn't break. It was just this one. And it's my favorite bronzer. Of course that would happen to me. Ooh, I love this brush for bronzer. Oh, wow. It blends out so seamlessly. Okay, so when I first got these Morphe brushes and I opened them, they smelled chemically. Like, they smelled like chemicals. Like, did that happen to you guys too? Because I mean, I got my sister one too for her birthday, and she said it smelled like chemicals too. Oh, right. And then for blush, I'm gonna be taking Milani's Luminoso with that Morphe angled brush. I know, guys, I'm applying blush before my highlight. What? There's always room for new things, you know? So, you guys, you can't say blush does not make a difference because, yes, it does. Just not too much, you know? You don't want to look like a clown. So let's have a little short story time. I got my makeup done and she made me look like a clown. Literally a clown. She put on so much blush on me and bronzer. Literally, I looked like a clown. I'm not gonna lie. And I saw my boyfriend that day. I wasn't planning on seeing him or anything. And I randomly saw him. And guys, I hid from him. Are you kidding me? I hid from my own boyfriend. Like, dude, it was that bad. You know, I was saving myself. For highlighter, I'm gonna be taking Mary's Luminizer. You know, this shit's my jam. This stuff is bomb. And I'm taking this Morphe brush as well. Ooh, I like this. I like this brush for highlighter. What? It packs on perfectly, like, not too much, just in the middle. I like to add my highlight like around the apples of my cheeks because like when I smile, I want it to be popping, you know, popping. I like to add highlighter on my cupid's bow too, even though it looks like mucus, you know? And I'm taking that angled brush again, just to blend it out. For my lower lash line, I'm gonna be taking that orangey brown shade. Then I'm gonna be taking in that purpley shade. I'm gonna be applying that right above that. All right, I'm gonna be taking that same brush I used for my transition shade. I'm gonna be taking a little bit more of that transition shade, and I'm just gonna be blending that out. Then I'm gonna be taking this gel liner. It's from Maybelline, and I'm only gonna be applying that on the outer portion of my waterline. I don't want my eyes looking so much smaller, so I'm only gonna be adding that to the outer portion of my waterline. And you don't wanna forget your upper waterline. So I applied my lipstick on camera, but I used the Lita number 2 by Kat Von D, and I used NYX's lip liner in brown as well. So I'm gonna set my face with Max Fix Bliss as usual. I love the smell of Max Fix Plus. I'm not gonna lie, I love it so much. So, I'm gonna be applying mascara to my lower lashes. I'm gonna be taking this gold shade and that gold shade right there. Definitely, yeah, this is super pretty, guys. Just packing that right on top of the Merrim Luminizer. I love it, guys. I love it. It's super pigmented and super buttery. Let me swatch it for you. Wow. I barely swiped it. Like, I barely swiped it. I'm not kidding. They feel like they're a cream highlighter, but they're not. Like, it's super bomb. Like, I love it. Okay, so my final thoughts, honestly, about this. Okay, I'm gonna go with the brushes first on my final thoughts. Okay, so definitely, I wanna say I highly, highly recommend these brushes. Especially for $40, come on guys, you can never go wrong with $40. Especially with a brush of 12, if it comes with a set of 12 brushes for $40, that is really cheap, guys. Like, that's super cheap, because if you get it from Sigma or from, say, Zoeva, probably get like 2 brushes for like $40. I'm not even kidding. It's so expensive. Brushes nowadays are so expensive. That's why I only go with Morphe, because honestly, Morphe brushes are so comparable to high-end brushes. I can't even tell the difference, honestly, when it comes to Morphe brushes. But I never really blend out my foundation with stippling brushes anyways, but I wanted to try it for the sake of the video. But honestly, I like how it turned out. If you don't have a lot of time when it comes to makeup, then I do not recommend you blending out your foundation with a stippling brush. But other than that, all the brushes are bomb. Brush, I loved it to just pack on the under eye highlight. That was bomb. That packed on perfectly. I have nothing bad to say about that. This packing brush didn't pack on good when it came to packing on shimmering eyeshadows, but I will try this again if I wanna use a smoky eye, or I just wanna pack on like a matte eyeshadow on my lids, and I'll definitely give that a try again. Comes with a case already, like, can't go wrong with that. And it comes with a little cover thing. I'm not gonna cover it right now. This brush set is seriously perfect for traveling. I'm not gonna lie, this is perfect for traveling. This is all you need when it comes to traveling. So my overall thoughts on this palette, I have to say, is a 10 out of 10. This is a 10 out of 10, guys. All the shades are pigmented as fuck. And usually matte shades aren't as pigmented as the shimmery shades, but they're both just as pigmented. So what can you say about that? What can you say about that? You know you can't say anything wrong about that. And the highlighters, I mean, look. Whew. This is on top of Merrim Luminizer, but still, like, girl. Well, these are definitely comparable to Morphe's price line, but they're just as bonk. Look, I love the color selection. You literally leave town with just these two and you'll be good, literally. So both are A pluses. Pause this video and go buy them online. Go buy them online. I'm telling you, you won't regret it. You won't regret it. So that wraps up today's video, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed my little first impression video on the Copper Brush Set by Morphe and the Carly Bible Deluxe Palette. But that's it. I'll see you guys on my next video. Bye, guys.